Hi everyone, it's me again. For the last video, I've introduced Nitrofosca Triple 15, which is one of the main products from Behn Meyer. And right now, I'm going to make comparison between Nitrofosca Triple 15 and YaraMila Triple 15. As we can see, Behn Meyer and Yara, both companies are the epitome of high quality assurance, prestige brands that farmers will pursue just by hearing the name. And now here comes the question. Between Yara and Nitrofosca, which one is better? And I believe everyone has the same problem choosing one of them. Now, if you are a buyer, which one you think is better? Is it Behn Meyer or is it Yara? First thing first, before to make this comparison fair and square, apple to apple, I'm not using 16-16-16, but instead I'll using YaraMila Triple 15. The reason is both share the same quantitative chemical formula. And another thing, Behn Meyer doesn't have Triple 16 to make comparison with YaraMila counterpart. So without further ado, let's begin. The content. First of all, these two fertilizers has an equal ratio of NPK of 15%, suitable for small or young plants such as vegetable, and for post-harvest stage such as fruit trees or durian trees. And right now we can look at the table of the contents. They all have the same amount of NPK, only have slight differences between the nitrate and ammonical based nitrogen and also phosphorus based composition. And the common features is that both using water soluble potassium oxide. And here comes the key differences. In terms of secondary element, Nitrofosca only have 2% of sulfur, and surprisingly YaraMila Triple 15 have 2% of sulfur and extra 2.5% of calcium, but both do not have trace elements. From this case, YaraMila actually has a better content compared to Nitrofosca. And next, here comes the structure. Structures will be including size and the surface texture of the fertilizer, because both factors will determine how fast the extent of fertilizers able to dissolve completely. This is important when you are picking the right fertilizers that complement the climate and surrounding condition. For Triple 15 case, Nitrofosca and YaraMila fertilizers are designed in granular shape. The only difference is that YaraMila fertilizer has a slightly smaller surface area compared to Nitrofosca. Based on logic, smaller surface area fertilizer will have higher solubility compared to the bigger one. And of course, provided they have the same mass, density, and the chemical content. Just like when we are eating, are we going to cut up small pieces of food and eat it, or we should put a whole chunk of food inside our mouth? And of course, eating small pieces of food will digest better. And this same goes to plants as well. Since the fact that Nitrofosca Triple 15 has lower solubility compared to YaraMila, it is more suitable to be applied during rainy season. This is because the fertilizer is designed to be more water resilient and it takes much longer time to completely dissolve. Therefore, if your location rains frequently, living in highland area, cold and cloudy, or when the time we are entering rainy season, then you should consider buying this fertilizer. On the flip side, everything is kinda opposite when it comes to YaraMila Triple 15. Due to this high solubility in nature, makes it much easier to dissolve in any soil condition, even with little presence of water. And that makes YaraMila Triple 15 a much viable choice in hot condition, especially in drought season. And right now we have done with this part. For the next part is pretty important to all of us. Of course, this is about the pricing. And now the price of these two fertilizers are getting out of hand. Prices are skyrocketed these days due to raw material shortages, and recent wars erupted in Ukraine and Russia worsened the situations, and farmers forced to buy expensive fertilizer. These are the historic price that we extracted from last 2 years compared to the current prices charged. From the year 2018, the Nitrofosca Triple 15 cost about 115 to 125 ringgit, whereas YaraMila costs about 125 ringgit. For the year 2019, Nitrofosca price remained unchanged, but YaraMila showed an increment of 10 ringgit in year 2019. In year 2020, the price of both fertilizer has dropped, but from year 2021 to 2022, both fertilizer has increased tremendously, from 125 ringgit to 180 ringgit. That showed an estimated increment of 50% compared to the last 2 years. In short, both fertilizers' prices were going to increase for the following years, and that makes that even less attractive with that kind of price point. And now here comes to our closing thoughts. Both of these fertilizers are excellent on their own, just with a few minute differences. Based on the market value, YaraMila 1515 is slightly more expensive compared to Nitrofosca 1515. What justifies the price is that YaraMila contain 2.5% more calcium compared to Nitrofosca. Also, Yara utilize smart nutrient technology that maximize phosphorus utilization. And of course, the last one is about branding. Based on our experience, YaraMila fertilizer is always more expensive compared to Nitrofosca. By the way, regardless of this comparison, you should buy both fertilizer while stock lasts, especially during this raw material shortages crisis. That's all for today, thank you for watching. If you have any question, just drop down the comment section. Until then, I'll see you on the next video.